camera rolling. Sound rolling. Yeah.
We are too.
Y'all rolling too, yeah. Everybody's rolling.
I stole it. He said it first. I said it louder.
When Gucci said that shit, I got it from Gucci.
I didn't even hear you. I just seen look at me smiling.
He was like, rolling. Well, I'm rolling too. Shout out Gucci Man, especially 08 Gucci Man.
The best Gucci Man.
Fly Anakin, Young Morpheus, welcome to 997.
Yo, bless,
thanks,
man.
Thanks for having us on.
Thanks for having me.
How y'all living?
Man, we're living a dream.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Welcome to New York.
Thanks for having us in New York.
Mid-tour?
It's not a mid-tour.
It's not a tour?
I'm joking.
He said it's an I-grid tour.
Before we get into it, do y'all both mind introducing yourselves? Talk a little bit about kind of where you come from and what you do.
Word. I'll let you hit it first, Frank.
Pause.
Stop it. Jesus Christ. Free us from these chains.
I blame Foyzy. So, yeah, my name is Fly Anakin. I come from a group called Mutant Academy. I am from a place called Richmond, Virginia. I live in a place called Atlanta, Georgia at the moment. I'm 28 of them things. Yo, yiddy, young and turnt. I got a PlayStation 5 and an Xbox. I'll shoot you on anything. My favorite color. I don't even have a favorite color. Yeah, man. I'm a grown up. I don't take no shit. Unless you my dog, then I'll take little shit. Jokes. Especially not taking no shit if you my dog, because you supposed to be my dog. What the fuck is you doing bullshit? It's me, man. I'm outside. New York. New York City. High 90. I mean, 997. Stop 97. Dot 97. You did. I'm going to shut up with him.
I'm Young Morpheus. Niggas is from Miami. Niggas be making rap music. You know what I mean? I like dogs.
Yeah.
And cooking a lot.
Same. How long have y'all known each other?
As long as I've known Pink Sifu and Ali and a couple other people in the scene. But probably like 2016, I met this nigga.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And he had the hammock in the crib.
You know what I'm saying?
If you know, you know.
Yeah. The ill little dog. Shout out to my nigga Booker. Wherever you at.
You think he's still alive?
Bro, he's still alive. She got him.
Oh. We ain't go
there. Yeah, no.
Just gonna say peace to the God.
Yeah, my nigga.
Yeah. So y'all on tour right now. Y'all both dropped projects back in April.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But kind of before, I feel like for the last few years, y'all have both been like just crazy consistent and highly like just prolific with the shit, where y'all are dropping multiple projects a year, back to back to back. I guess, what is that work ethic like? Like, are y'all just, is it putting a project together or getting in the studios that you're pumping out multiple tracks in a night in a session? Or is it just like, you know, you're going hard and really putting these projects together and you know, dropping 3-4 in a year.
For me personally, I feel like it's just because niggas be rapping a lot. You know what I mean? Like, yeah, I need that shit to be all right. So, like, I'm going to do it often.
Yeah.
And there be certain ideas that niggas want to flesh out. So niggas flesh them out, you know what I mean? But I feel like it's rare that it's like, yo, I'm gonna go into the studio and do 26 songs, and you know what I mean? Like, if that happened, it happened. But niggas like stacking and
like,
looking
at
the
like
shit.
You feel like
you've
been going crazy hard, or is it just kind of like that's how you work?
Yeah, it don't feel like that. It feel like that's the pace. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? For sure.
I think on my end, I'm like, I do this shit in spurts at this point, because at one point in my life, I used to just do that all day long, and I surrounded myself with people that do that all day long, so whenever I'm around them, I do that shit all day long, but when I'm not in the mood, I don't force that shit, so I be in my own world a lot, and I allow myself to live life so I can actually have something to rap about,
yeah.
Because I feel like at one point in my life, I burnt myself, you know what I mean, in the space of just expressing a little too fucking much, for real, for real. So honestly, I took a step back and really just started focusing on each individual project that I'm trying to put together and shit. But I have a lot of stuff in the tuck too, so it kind of put me in a space where I don't feel like I got a rush right now.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But I'm also still trying to figure out that next step and, you know what I mean, developing future projects and shit, and also adding more projects when I don't have the time or the space to work on them bitches, but I still do it because it's kind of just part of it, you know what I mean? Like, I went through my like my notes. I got this little like a note in my thing or whatever, and it's all my projects that I released since 2009, and I just be looking at that shit every time I feel like I'm bullshitting. And it's like 40 something projects on that motherfucker.
Yeah.
Like, hell, the stuff that ain't came out was like in the mix and shit. So I'm like, I keep up with what I got going on, but I also just don't get drowned in this shit no more. It's like I don't lose myself in the work anymore. It's like I'm kind of just like taking care of myself right now. And then it's like niggas be having to go on tour, so it's kind of weird, like trying to make sure I know these old ass songs and making new songs in the process. I be kind of fucking myself up. So yeah, admittedly, I took a step back just so I could focus on the artistry.
You feel like you burnt yourself out doing all that?
Yeah. Hell yeah, like right before the pandemic though. So like a lot of the shit that I needed is like kind of coming right back now.
Yeah.
You feel me? Like, especially since niggas started touring. Like, I've been touring since the world opened up, for real, for real. So like, I feel like a new artist in a lot of ways. Like, I don't do shit the way I used to do it no more.
Yeah. I think, you know, speaking of giving like more attention to a project and like thinking about that more deliberately almost, I think around when Frank came out, I had seen kind of you speaking about taking a little more time and energy to like think about song structure and building a song out, thinking about hooks and like that kind of stuff. How has that kind of process evolved, and like, does that change the way you kind of write and record now?
No, still the same shit.
Yeah.
I'll just be adding like a little more like melodic stuff, like little melodies and shit, just because I know that's what's gonna keep them motherfuckers clicking. It's like, I know how this shit work. So I'm just playing the game right now. It's like, I know what motherfuckers want. I just know what I'm willing to do. So like, it's certain shit that I'm learning about myself every year where I'm like, all right, cool, I kind of do like doing this. I'm going to figure out a way to do this in my own way. And in the process of doing that, motherfuckers would be like, yo, you should do this, you should do this, you should do that. You know what I mean? But like, I just be like in the cut, like, nah, nigga, I'm working on it. Don't worry about that. It's really like, yeah, that's me all day long.
Y'all both have like...
For the hotties.
Y'all both have been pretty active in terms of like collaborating, you know, whether it's like doing joint projects with someone. I know Anakin, you got like the whole crew from back home.
Shout out Mutant Academy. A lot of them niggas is in town right now.
Yeah. How has that and like, I guess for you both, like dropping, you know, recent albums that allow you to kind of stand on your own. Mm-hmm. How does that process change, or do you look at that album differently when you're like, this is me now? Mm-hmm. Like, Morpheus, for you, like, mm-hmm. for the latest record, like, you know, you're standing on your own too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, I feel like... For this joint, I was more like personal than I was willing to be in the past, because it was just all my shit, and there isn't that like inherent like soundboard that you have when someone else is producing. You know what I'm saying? Like, there's another nigga who'll be like, "Bro, that's it." I'm like, "That's not it." You know what I'm saying? But Yeah, I feel like it was mainly different in that regard. I don't think I came at the music any differently than that. Like, you know, I'm gonna be wild honest and like try to show all the shit that I fuck with. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like really let niggas know, like, yo, this is all of it. Or at least this is a baseboard to really be like, oh, okay, that's a full plate. That, like, you know what I mean? It's like if you came to my crib for like a dinner party and I was just making everything as opposed to like
potluck.
If, yeah, like going to, like, yo, come to me and my girl spot and we both, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. She gonna make some shit, I'm gonna make some shit, we both gonna talk. And we gonna be like, well, the carrots kind of don't make sense because you doing it, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. This is just me with the little apron on.
That's the real album cover, just you with the little apron on.
Straight up. I'm about to get it on my...
Literally, a little apron.
A little Chef Boyardee. You got to be a tiny apron and a tiny hat.
Oh, my God.
A little hat and a little knife.
Y'all have also kind of, like, tapped in with dumb projects where it's just you and one producer.
Obligatory.
And worked with like a range of really talented producers from like, you know, Morpheus, you got the record with iDress. You know, Anakin, you've worked with Madlib and you just dropped the record with Foyzy. I know both of you guys produce as well. How involved are y'all in like the production process?
If I ain't make that beat, I ain't involved in the production process, because that's the point of it, because... It's I wanted to make a collaborative thing. So I don't know, when I'm if me and Foyzy got beats that we made like on some collaborative effort shit, you know what I mean? I usually don't even rap on them motherfuckers because I prefer just the Foyzy shit, because that nigga hard vibe. So like, I don't know, you know your chemistry, we know what makes sense as an artist. So like, I can't even remember the question. What happened again? What was the question?
How involved are you in production?
Oh yeah, like I said, I'm involved with it if I did that shit myself.
Yeah.
Especially if I did it myself, because I just like recently did something like that I don't usually do. But I made a beat for myself, mixed that shit, mastered it, and fucking sat back and listened to that bitch. And I was like, damn, I can really do this.
if I really wanted to.
Yeah, like if I really I've produced a project for myself, but I'm like, I just be like doing certain things to prove it to myself, to make sure I know how to do it, and then I'll just be like, fuck that shit, I don't care. So like, that's where I'm at with production, like for the most part. I'm just be like, I don't care, make a beat. But then I make a beat and I be like, damn, this shit hard, and I make another one, and I make another one, and as soon as I strike out, I'll just be like, fuck making beats for like another week. But then it's like, you know,
I feel you sometimes, it be like that. I'm gonna go rap now. I'm a rapper now.
Yeah, it's like I literally changed the hat whenever I can't, like, you know what I mean? I'm like, fuck that rap shit right now, I'm making beats. It's like sometimes I'm opposite way. It's like, it's an interesting process, but definitely like my friends make great fucking beats. Like them niggas produce their asses off. So I don't think I have to be a producer. Like, it's not mandatory for me to do this shit. I only do this because it's ironic. It's kind of funny. It's like, oh, that nigga can do both. Nah, whatever. Like, that's it. It's like, it ain't really nothing else for that for me. I'm a rapper first. You know what I mean? I will give up producing today if it ever meant I couldn't rap no more.
Yeah.
It's like, that shit is just like a skill thing for me. I want to make sure I can do it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's love in it, but it ain't like a bunch of passion. Like, that's why I'm not producing a million projects for niggas. I would like to, though. It's a couple niggas I want to do that for, and I'm going to do that whenever I make my way around to it, because I have to give a fuck. Like, you know what I mean? I got to be in the mood where I want to do it. If I'm touring, I'm probably not making beats.
Yeah, yeah.
It's like, I be doing too much. It's like, I'm either, if it's going up for me, I probably ain't got time for some shit that I want to do, and that's the trade-off.
Yeah.
It be like that.
Morpheus, you feel the same?
Yeah, yeah. I feel like, yeah, nah, if I ain't make that shit, I'm not touching it. You know what I'm saying? That there might have been one time where I was like, yo, how it sound without drums? And the nigga showed me without drums, and then I fucked with it. And you know what I'm saying? Yeah. That's probably it, though. Because like Frank was saying, that's the whole fun of doing that shit.
Yeah.
And having niggas being like, yo, boom, here's a palette, what we on? I'm like, you know what? Let's go wherever you're trying to take it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'm like,
trust in the process.
Yeah, for sure, in that regard. And I'm a fucking asshole with my own shit. That's why I barely even be producing for myself often. This might have been the most that there's been, like, production of my own on a record with this last joint type shit. Because I'd be too, like, nah. And, like, to what bro was saying, like, niggas is fans. You know what I'm saying? I'm a fan of beats.
Yeah.
And, like, I'm not as good as all of these fucking niggas. Niggas been making beats since I was a baby. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Some of these cats, like, yeah, I'm a fan. So I'm going to always be that first when it comes to the production shit.
Facts.
You know what I mean?
So y'all both are on the same label. Latest records dropped on Lex Records.
Yeah.
Which is quite a legendary label. With Danger Doom, Gnarls Barkley, Ghostface shit.
Mm-hmm.
What does it mean to y'all to, like, be working with a label like that? And how has that kind of, like, I don't know, elevated your music, I guess, or just careers in general?
You got it, Frank.
Lex really, like, the first motherfuckers to be like, all right, we love what you do. We got this amount. What's up? and we gonna make sure you taken care of, and we gonna get your ass on the road. You know what I mean? Like, they did a lot. You know what I mean? I fuck with Lex, and from my travels and shit, it's just been showing me, like, what a label could and supposed to be. Cause I've been on, like, little fucking makeshift labels, like little like a SoundCloud label. You remember
insert
those
tapes? Like,
oh Lord, yes, exactly. All the yes, like, we've been through them times where it was like it felt like shit was getting to a point where it was real, but it was never really like what it was supposed to be. But Lex, like, niggas like a real label. You know what I mean? Like, I ain't never seen a label move like that, and they're not major. It's like, that's really like my reasoning of going to Lex is because, like, I want to be able to do the things, but I don't want to be on a major because I know them niggas is going to neglect my shit. So, like, just to stay out of that and be in a space where I can be in a room with the motherfucker that signed the check and the motherfuckers that's, like, pushing this shit and, like, running the label, you know what I mean? Like, I fuck with that aspect of it. Like, it feel like a family in so many ways and shit. So that's how I feel about it, you know? So, like, granted, minus the history, because I don't know all the history. Yeah. It's like, right now, I fuck with what Lex got going on.
Yeah, facts.
All right, so. I feel that. I think I agree with all of that. And then I feel like my shit might have been a little informed by that catalog, for sure. And being like, all right, those are some ill records, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
I remember when them shits came out, I was a jet, you know what I mean?
Like, yeah.
That naturally plays a role, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to Doom. You know what I mean?
Facts.
For real.
For real.
Shout out to Ghost. Wish that joint would have happened.
And Gnarls Barkley.
Yeah.
Shout out to CeeLo, man. No, of course. Of course.
Go to the office, they got the shit on the wall. Like the plaque and shit. That shit be putting me in my bag every time. Like, I'm going to get one of these motherfuckers.
Niggas is really doing it, man.
Because it's like, that shit, like, it'll just show you that it's possible in your circumference. Like, it's something about that. Like,
that's
people
well
think
said.
When you win, like, you just immediately out of their fucking reach. You know what I mean? It's like, motherfuckers be in your circumference and they can make things happen, and it's all in how the team form itself around that artist, for real, for real.
Yeah.
Sometimes it could work, sometimes that shit don't. But the motherfuckers took a chance on the nigga. It took a chance on my nigga over here. Yeah. Took a chance on my nigga Chuck Strange. Took a chance on my nigga Fly Seafood and motherfucking B Kool-Aid. It's like, we've been doing this shit for a long time, but it's like, not everybody gonna put some bread behind this shit. So,
that's real.
Yeah, I think to
that's
that
real.
Point, like, I feel like it was maybe a year ago or a year or two ago, when Frank dropped, but I seen you had a quote talking about, like, you know, almost like, fuck being underground. Like, you know, I'm trying to be, like, you know, established.
Being underground I don't even know how to say it exactly, but it's not lame. I was about to just go out, jump out the window and be like, being underground is lame, because it's not. I actually fuck with being underground. But it's a cap on that shit, bro. And I don't believe in a cap, like, when we are who we are. Like, so, like, it's a reason why I said that. But, like, ultimately, yeah, I'm going to be underground forever, like, in my heart. But if I was to blow the fuck up, I'm not about to just be mad at myself or mad at my fans. I'm just I'm gonna live with the shit that fucking signed up for.
Not being underground doesn't mean you sold out. It just means you're trying to reach a wider audience.
It's like at the end of it, it's like if I make decisions that I wanted to make along the way, I don't give a fuck what nobody got to say about how my career was. Like, nigga, you ain't pay my bills. You ain't take care of my family. I don't give a fuck about none of that shit. So when it comes down to it, of like, if I made a decision and it was a little wonky, it's like, you got it. You say what you want to say. But as long as I'm happy with that decision, you know what I mean? That's the most important shit. It's like everybody got shit going on, but your decisions is your decisions. Like whether they work or they don't work, nigga, that's your decision.
So, nigga. Do what the fuck you wanna do.
Literally, bro.
Yeah.
It's like that's the fucking the thing of the century, bro. It's like do what you wanna do. For the reasons that you want to do that shit, because when you do it for the wrong reasons, you end up in a bad spot.
And I think that's like a fair. Honestly, we've had a couple conversations with different artists this year that are, you know, around the same like later 20s, been making music for like over a decade, at different levels of like if you know you know, and just getting to a place where there's a perspective shift where it's like. I'm really trying to level up, and whether that informs the music, whether that informs the how you see your career and what kind of energy you're giving, I don't know. I think that's real, and that's like a very worthwhile shift.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that shit important, bro.
That shit important, bro. Fuck all that shit. Niggas be trying to pigeonhole you so they can pay you less.
Not facts.
Straight up.
Yeah, facts.
In the name of hip hop.
Yeah.
Niggas trying to make you pay your dues.
Yeah, bro.
Shit like that.
Beneath the soil. Trying to grow like a plant, dog. You know what I mean? I'm not a potato. I want to be a flower, dog.
Yeah, bro.
I'm not a potato.
You know what I'm saying? Like, underground. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Like carrot, nigga. Carrots.
So, y'all got. A collab joint.
Yeah, we do. Yeah.
Morpheus on your record.
Yes.
Cassava Bread.
Cassava.
Cassava.
You good.
I tried. You I snapped, was trying though. To remember how you we slid. Said it earlier.
I feel you. You still slid, though. I wouldn't believe that. You know what I mean? If I didn't know, I would have been like, yeah.
Low-key, a culinary anthem. But
word. That's hard. That's
the bars,
hard.
The bars in the video.
Hey man, bless. You know
but
saying?
I'm wondering kind of how that track came about. Yeah, for both of you.
Word.
I'm gonna give you my perspective first because it ain't as glamorous.
Nice. Yeah, you should. You should.
I'm gonna do that real quick. So that nigga just hit me up like, "Yo, you fuck with this jump?" It's like, "Yeah, gonna get on this jump." Yeah, I'll do it. My brother produced it. My nigga never did nothing. Like I was telling you about this shit in the car. In
yeah,
Chicago.
Yeah, yeah. Yep.
It was like I got like a gauge of how I determine whether I'm gonna do something for or with somebody. I'm like, have they ever did anything to me or anybody around me that I care about? You know what I mean? Nah, I ain't do nothing to nobody. Do I fuck with that nigga? Yeah, I fuck with more. Is this shit hard? Yeah, this shit hard. I did it.
Yeah.
Boom.
And then I can't remember how it worked out. I definitely took a picture. This nigga was like, "Yo," or something. He was checking in on that shit, and I was right behind.
Yeah, I was finishing that shit.
I just finished recording that bitch.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, that was
it. That little picture marked the moment of completion for that verse.
Look, it's done now, bro. I know.
Yeah. Simple though.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, it really was simple as that. And I had originally just went to Grey Matter House to like listen to joints and shit. And that was one of the joints that I laid some shit on. And I was like, I like this a lot. I can't remember. The sample reminded me of some shit that I used to like a lot when I was a kid. Like some Daft Punk song that I can't remember right now. But I was like geeked off of that. Some niggas just rhymed on it, you know what I'm saying? The food shit kind of just be, so that wasn't as necessarily, like, on the nose with intention, you know what I'm saying? That's, like, really what niggas is on.
Yeah.
Type shit. Like,
is that, like, the beat even reminding you of something from childhood and then you start Yeah. Like that goes off into like you're remembering like the food that you're eating and shit.
You
like
feel
that.
Me? Type shit. Exactly. Exactly. That's why niggas said the shit about like my auntie potato salad and shit.
Yo,
like
I love that line. Yeah,
that's some real shit. Shout out to Relish.
Shout out to the Relish and the
niggas
potato
be salad. Disrespecting the Relish, bro.
Bro, I will never do that after seeing how it was used. You know what I'm saying?
Man.
For real.
Shout out Relish, dog.
And we were talking about sponsor that video a little Relish. Bit beforehand, but in that video, you're really in the kitchen.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Sure. You be in the kitchen like that?
Yeah, man. Yeah.
That nigga ain't making no duck at the crib, man.
You said what?
That nigga ain't making no duck at the
don't
crib.
Do that, bro. Don't
I got
do
it. Like I got to say it, bro. I just got to say it.
Is that what you made
I
in the video?
Yeah.
Duck?
Made duck
yeah.
Yeah.
So. Nigga made duck and it was good.
Man, I'll be cooking. He said, bro, you don't do that.
That was fire, bro. I've never seen a nigga cook a duck. I'm sorry. That shit was hard. That shit was hard.
You had the like fun. Sauce line.
Hey, man, you feel me? The little, you know what I'm saying? Little easy L'Orange sauce, you feel me? Less intensive joint. Right. Nah, niggas really be doing that, for sure. Yeah. Yeah.
I make hood shit. Like, I just be making, like, you know what I mean? Like, man. Pastas. And I got a waffle maker, nigga.
Bro, food is food,
I
mean,
nigga. I am waffle maker, too. I am Waffle House now. Fuck with your boy. I got y'all $17 a plate.
You know what I mean? What's on the plate?
Just the waffle. You paying for the experience.
You paying to pull up and watch me make it.
Nah, you're not gonna watch me make it, but I will definitely bring that bitch to the porch for you.
Damn, okay.
$17. All right.
The porch waffle for $17.
Nah, actually I can't do that because you can't be selling shit at the crib.
No.
Like, nah. I'll make a bundle, like a batch of them bitches. Like 40 waffles, right? Just hit the block.
Yo, drop it off like a brick somewhere.
You get a
yo,
waffle.
I left
you
40
get a waffle.
Waffles for you
nah,
in the parking
them,
lot.
But we ain't giving them up. I'm like, they gonna be a little cold, but I'm like, it's set up like this for you to microwave it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It got butter in the joint in the box. I'm gonna make boxes for these niggas. I'm bullshitting, but I really should do that.
Sure.
Just make waffles, nigga. You know how easy it is to make waffles?
It is. Don't tell them how easy, then they won't buy.
Yeah. Don't tell them the recipe.
Yeah.
Ain't no recipe, dog.
Well.
It's a recipe, but I ain't telling them niggas. You think I'm stupid? You think I'm fucking stupid?
Come on.
Come on,
man. Got a fucking noggin on me.
You see this fucking cranium kick?
Come on.
While y'all are here.
What's good?
And we got the studio.
Whew.
Y'all down to lay down a little live session of the track?
Oh, yeah.
Man. We guys make a new song?
Right.
Yo, you can do a new song if you want.
You just kick it here all day.
Yeah, that'd be hard.
You like that video of RZA on the beat joint? You seen that video? Where he making the garbage beat? It's like the commercial.
Yes. I didn't want to admit that I saw it.
Bro, what you mean? That shit is legendary.
It's funny, but it's
that's legendary. He's an actual madman.
I know.
Shout out to RZA.
I want to hear him rap on that beat.
About a sperm becoming going into the egg and being fertilized.
Mm-hmm.
I guess hey, also I'm wondering, last question, tour poster, Beavis and Butthead.
Yeah.
Y'all came up on Beavis and Butthead? You fuck with Beavis and Butthead?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I ain't gonna say I was like watching the show all the time, but I respect them niggas as people.
Yeah.
As humans, for real.
Exactly.
I fuck with Beavis and Butthead. Real niggas. Real niggas. And truthfully, when it came time to like figure out what we was gonna do for the tour, niggas just thought about them crazy ass duos. Like this nigga said, you said Tim and what was the nigga? I can't remember the name.
What the Bill and Ted shit?
Bill and Ted.
Yeah.
He said Bill and Ted, and I was like Beavis
like
and Butthead.
Shit like that. Yeah.
Yeah. And it just stayed at Beavis and Butthead. We need to name the tour. We was just like
no.
Yeah.
It works.
Them niggas.
It
works. Them niggas on the road. Go see them. Sometimes they sit on couches similar to this one.
And they smoke joints. Niggas be having this. All I'm missing is the ashtray right here.
Yeah. Well, all right, let's get it. Let's move over to the studio.
Young Morpheus, Fly Anakin, 997. What's up? Yeah, what up? Fuck you on, I made that cracker say please. Wasn't really trying to chat, I take the package and leave. Counting at the crib alone, stacking the cheese. A couple bands for the feature and a rack for the beats. sun gon' blaze until the rain come down. Out in South London, trying to make more pounds. Game got his head fucked up by the money chase, but can't eat shit without a dollar in your pocket. Heard him say you ain't a real killer till you kill one. Little nigga buggin', tripping off the gun's weight. Plenty cash gon' give you some game, some tape. Baby, can you take me with you with the dumb cake? Raw Hamachi got the chalice on it. Fronted on me then, now she want it. I need the big body with the leg space. Table for two at the homie spot for the test tasting. I can never knock another nigga hustle. Get your paper. Place grievances to the side. Read them later. Dominoes on the table. Fried fish with escovitch. I'm hoping I can trust the one who lay beside me. Stumbling towards the corner, he tried to shrug it off. Ain't handle it the proper way. Fumbled loss. Relish going side potato salad at my auntie crib. Your final offer need a triple that started the mount. Word. Yeah, uh-huh. The final offer need a triple to start an amount.
Yeah, say what it is, pimpin'. You know the Magnavox, Benevision, tackle box. We been fishing, break the lot. Bench feeling consecutive, pulled ups. Who up? I'm loud as shit. Stumble over broken bottles at the exit in the wrist. Switch fists in the telephone booth. It caught a switch. Want the fiend, I fell in lust. Wish you like it odorless. Posted like a sticky note. Quoted this. Automatic with terminology. Make the Goya flip. Judo kicks and toilet head. Law and order trips. My with the same niggas I had to split the order with. You seen it coming since back gaming, but now we bought the whip. Talk the border, bitch. Bet the grass green and dead. Feel it in the air. Well known phenoms unfair to the weak. Mind the rat to live blinded to get a point. They shoot the pilots. Keep the heat crowded. The steeds riding. The individual, your street crowded. Nigga.
It was one of those where it's like, it's a vibe.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.